Hello, if you have Photostream set up, every time you take a picture on your iOS device, whether it be your iPhone or your iPod, it will automatically stream this to your Mac straight away, even if you don't open iPhoto. Now this can take up a considerable amount of space, specifically if you take a lot of pictures but don't delete them off your Mac or delete them off iPhoto. For example, if we go to the go to folder, and type in --, library, application support, / iLive Asset Management, the past in the comments, and open this folder, we notice there's what a folder called assets. Now I've recently deleted this folder, however, if you had this a long time, this can get considerably large. For example, if you go in the assets subfolder, each of these folders contains an image. Every single one of these folders is an image you've taken on your iOS device or your iPad or iPhone or iTouch, pretty much anything that has Photostream connected to it. Today's post is going to show you how to delete these photos and how to save a little bit of space. Delete these folders and files by pressing Command A and hitting the delete button. However, this is a bit untidy and could force your Mac to be a bit out of sync with each other. So what we're going to do is we're going to open up System Preferences. We're going to do it a kind of official way. From this, we're going to select iCloud. Now you'll notice that within this, there's the Photostream options. If we click the Options button within Photostream, select the My Photostream tab. You can also probably select the Shared Photostream if you have multiple Photostreams, and then press OK. Now, a warning will come up saying, are you sure you want to turn off Photostream? And then a big glowing button. If you press turn off Photostream, you'll notice straight away within this folder that the files have been deleted. Your Mac now knows what it's doing and how it's deleted itself. This is sort of a better way of deleting these files, as iPhoto and your iPod or your iTouch or your iPad, iPhone, there's lots of I's in that, will know what it's doing with each other and they're deleted in a secure and more efficient way. Let's say we want to turn Photostream back on. We're in System Preferences again, the iCloud folder. When we select the Options button and the My Photostream option and press OK, your Mac will communicate with your iPad, iPod, iPhone, anything else that begins with an I and uses Photostream, and download only the latest Photostream files. Photostream on your Mac at least will store a lot of old files that you may have taken off iPhoto. So for example, within this subfolder again, and I open up this file, we've only got the latest image which I've just taken of my desktop on my iPod, on my iPad rather. Now if I open up iPhoto, and within the Photostream folder on the left, these 5-6 images are the latest file. I haven't got the thousands of previous Photostream files. Now this is a great way of deleting all these old files and saving a little bit of disk space, because this iLife Asset Management folder can get incredibly large. This is only 30 megabytes at the moment, but when I started this tip or this video to test these tools out, it was about a gigabyte. So that is a lot of files which is just sitting there on your Mac. If you have an SSD hard drive or something and it's starting to take up a lot of space, that can be considerable amount of space wasted. Of course, if you have Photostream open, you delete them off Photostream, you can still keep them within this folder. By using this tip, it will delete those files, clean up your disk.